Integromat webhooks are a great way to connect any service to start your automations on Integromat instantly when something happens on the other platform. In this video, I will show you exactly how you can use webhooks, how you can set them up on different systems, and what they can do for you. Hey, my name is Manuel. I'm the founder of Techflow AI, and in this video, I will show you exactly how you can work with Integromat webhooks and what kind of different webhook types there are, or hook types there are, and also what you can do with them. So first off, we will create a simple webhook by creating a new scenario inside of Integromat. Then you click on the plus symbol and you search for webhook. There are a lot of different systems coming up if you search for webhooks, because all of these actually offer webhooks as a trigger, which means they can kickstart your automations instantly when something happens on that platform. So we scroll down and select webhooks. Here we have two different types of triggers. One is the custom Mailhook. This is actually providing you an email address where you can send an email to, you can forward an email to, you can use advanced logics in your email system. For example, in Gmail, you can have filters that automatically forward emails that are coming from a specific person or have a specific subject line. You can forward them to this custom mail hook and it would automatically start that automation and also append all the email details to that webhook. So you have that information available and can automate cool things about that. That's actually what I am explaining inside of my free workshop, which you can access down below in the description. I am teaching you how you can use these mail hooks to your advantage, how you can extract any kind of information from these emails. But in this video, we want to focus on custom webhooks. A webhook is basically a URL that you can send data to. So I got the official definition here. A webhook in web development is a method of augmenting or altering the behavior of a web page or a web application with custom callbacks. These callbacks may be maintained, modified, and managed by third-party users and developers who may not necessarily be affiliated with the originating website or application. Yep, that sounds awful, right? So I just made it speed up because it's so boring. But here is my very short explanation in simple words. A webhook is a URL that you can trigger and append data to it. The webhook catches the data, processes it in a way that you want, and can even send data back. So that is my personal simple definition of what a webhook is and what it can do for you. I'd say let's go into some examples first, and then I'll show you how to set this up, because it might help you to understand what a webhook actually is. So one good example is Shopify. So you have all kinds of different events on Shopify. So it could be articles, blogs, custom collections, comments, orders, pages, price rules, products, and smart collections. For example, for articles, if the article was created, then you can send a notification to your system, to Integromat in that case, and say, hey, I got a new article. It was just created. I want to send it off to my social media or something like that. So you get an instant notification when this event happens. There's also published, unpublished, updated, and all these different events. Then, of course, the most important one is most likely orders. When an order was created, for example, like order confirmed, order fulfilled, order placed, and all these different events. You can use all of them and send a notification to your system and then kickstart your automation. Or you could use, for example, Calendly. If you're using a booking service, then you can send yourself a notification if a new booking happened, and then you can, for example, add it as a task in your project management tool. You can send a notification to Slack. You can prepare automatically some folders or documents that you will need for that call. So you can do all these things instantly. Another example is ManyChat. I'm using ManyChat for chatbot creation to develop all kind of different smart chatbots. And here you got external requests, which is basically a webhook where you send data to. So you can put the URL of your webhook here and then send data, for example, full contact data or specific custom fields. You can send it to that scenario on Integromat, and then you can do automations based on that. And we also have the dynamic content where you can also put in a webhook and a body. And the main difference between these two is this one, the external request, just sends data off. And the dynamic content, it sends data and waits for 10 seconds to receive data back. and then you can do like further automation with that. So let's get into how to set this up. So we have the custom webhook. We just create a new one. You can give it any name that you want. So it's a YouTube webhook, and you also got some advanced settings. So you could define the data structure. I recommend leaving that empty because Integromat will automatically define the data structure. Then you could also get the request headers if you need them, request method. This is advanced. You don't have to worry about that for now. And also you can use JSON pass through if you want to modify the raw data of it. So that's also not recommended in most cases, but I just wanted to mention it here so you know that these options actually exist. Now, when I click on save, I got this URL here, which I can copy to my clipboard. And now I can add it to the location where I send the notification off. So that could be in Shopify under notifications, or that could be in your scheduling system, or it could be on ManyChat like in that case. And then I can click on test the request in ManyChat and it will say successfully determined. So it is waiting for data. And once you send data once to that webhook, Integromat knows what kind of data to expect. And only then you can map it to the following modules. So if I have variable here, so tools set variable, I use that a lot of times for testing things. Then we see that there's nothing from the webhook because I didn't send any data in my body. So it just sent notification but didn't attach any data. So I can add full contact data and try it again. So if I go back here and click on redetermine data structure, so Integromat knows what kind of data to expect, and I test the request again, then it says, okay, successfully determined. And if it's refreshing metadata, and now I see all these variables that are available because they have been sent inside of the webhook. So that is great. Now I can use this data to map it in further modules and do whatever I want with it. So for example, let's use the ID because that's kind of easy. It's the subscriber ID and I want to get that out. So I just run it once and now trigger it again, test the request. And you see all the data here that is coming in. And then also you see the subscriber ID and the ID got extracted. So that way you can automate kind of anything. It will run instantly, which means it will only run when a notification is arriving, when an event is happening, and only then it will continue and start your automation. That is very helpful because in Integromat, you are built based on operations. So that means every time you have to check if you put it on a schedule, so let's say at regular intervals, every 5 minutes, then it would cost you one operation every 5 minutes, even if there's no data. But with webhooks, then it will happen instantly and will just use operations when there's an actual event. So if you like this video, just hit the like button below the video and also subscribe to my channel. I will have a lot of more tutorials coming up over the next 2 weeks, like every week, one great tutorial about Integromat and automation in general. So stay tuned for more. Now that we covered the webhooks, there's also the webhook response, and that is what we are using for the dynamic content here, for example. That is when you want to send data back, like a response back to that webhook. By default, if you don't have this webhook response module set up, it will send back 200 and accept it. So I can run this once and test this request again. And then you can see the response is accepted and a 200. So that's everything that you would get back by default. But if you set up a webhook response, then you can set up something else, for example, 400. So you got this 400 error code, bad request, and response body is failure. So that way you can like send data back. I've got a different video on how to create a BMI calculator where I explain exactly how you can use the webhook response, for example, with HTML. So if you call that URL, it will do some automation in the backend and then send it back to you and display a nicely formatted website with all the information that you've gotten from your automation. So that's super helpful and the webhook response is very good for that. You just have to keep in mind that most services expire, so they don't wait forever for the webhook response. So in that case, you might think about using a different way of returning the data instead of having the webhook response. All right, that was it about webhooks. It's super short, super quick, but it's super powerful. And I'm using webhooks wherever I can because they work instantly and I don't have to put them on a schedule. If you like this video, click the like button, subscribe to my channel, and watch out for more videos that are upcoming about automation and Integromat in general. Thank you very much for watching.